Gandhi ji, respected Rahul ji, Congress Working Committee members, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, today it's a unique day in the history of the Congress Party. You will forgive me if I do not become somewhat emotional on this historic occasion. I recall in a letter that Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru wrote to Indira ji, advising her that in the affairs of the state one cannot be sentimental, though one should be full of sentiments. However, I seek your forgiveness for not being able to resist the element of emotionalism in the few words that I am going to make. Sonia ji has been the leader of the Congress Party for 19 years. In these 19 years, I have been associated with Sonia ji as a member of the Congress Working Committee and 10 years as Prime Minister of our country. During this period, the powerful leadership that Sonia ji has provided to the Congress Party is something which will be remembered in the annals of history of the Congress Party. As Prime Minister for 10 years, I had the unique privilege of the guidance of Srimati Sonia Gandhi ji, and in those 10 years, we took some historic decisions. The growth rate of the country was the all-time high. The average growth rate was 7.8% per annum. 140 million people were lifted from poverty in this period of 10 years. A large and in some ways unique social legislation was enacted. MNREGA is one of them. Right to information is yet another. And several other social legislations were enacted under the guidance of Srimati Sonia Gandhi. Now that Sonia ji is handing over the reins of the Congress President to Rahul ji, we salute Sonia ji for the magnificent leadership that she has provided in these last 19 years. Rahul ji has been trained for a long period. He has been looking after many of the activities of the Congress Party for many years, and he brings to this office of the Congress President a new sense of dedication, a new sense of commitment, a new sense of looking after the leadership role with courage and humility. Rahul ji today is taking over as the president of our party at a time when there are certain disturbing trends noticeable in our polity. As a distinguished academic pointed out a few days ago, there are dangers that the politics of fear will take over from the politics of hope. Rahul ji we depend upon you to transform that area, that sphere of politics, to transform, to sustain the politics of hope which this country needs. Our country's problems are problems of poverty, ignorance and disease which still afflict millions and millions of our people. Rahul ji, you have travelled all over the country. You know these problems firsthand as nobody else knows, and we therefore trust that under your distinguished leadership, our party will scale new heights of glory. With these words, I join all congressmen and congresswomen in all parts of our country in conveying our good wishes to Rahul ji. May your path be blessed.